Monkeys and baboons. Now, monkeys and baboons are often words that are confusing for many people that are trying to tell these primates apart, including humans, of course. But if you've seen animals protesting, those are baboons. Now, baboons protesting at one of the killings of their group members disrupted traffic on a busy Tororo Jinja highway in eastern Uganda. Now, besides baboons being more rowdy than monkeys, there's definitely a lot more classic differences between these very, very individually different animals, but often mistaken by other human beings. Check this out. From head to bottom, baboons grow 20 to 34 inches and their tails add an additional 16 to 24 inches to their length. They weigh about as much as a human child, 22 to 37 kilograms. Monkeys can range in size, with the smallest being 4 to 6 inches with a 6.8 inch tail, weighing 100 grams, to 3.3 feet weighing 36 kilograms. Monkeys have small arms and long legs, and opposable thumbs on both their hands and legs, and contrary to popular beliefs, monkeys do not swing as their arms are weak. They are more prone to running on branches and climbing to the top of the treetops. The baboon certainly does have many characteristics that are different from other monkeys. They have a long snout, which looks almost like a dog's muzzle, a very long and large nose. The males have a nose that can be up to 7 times larger than that of a female. Monkeys, however, have a very flat nose. You will also notice that the baboon features teeth that are extremely sharp compared to other monkeys. It certainly gives them an appearance of being mean, and that could be an advantage when it comes to predators. Yet that also has a dark side to it in society, as many cultures think that baboons are evil. The baboons have two premolars. The premolar in the mandible is sectorial. It's specialized for sharpening the upper canines. The molars have sharply connected cusps. Monkeys, on the other hand, have free premolars. The molars are relatively large and the last molar is comparatively small and sometimes absent. In baboons, the thumbs are rotated and more opposable, more like ours. Fingernails and toenails are present on all digits. In monkeys, the thumb orientation lies in line with other digits, opposes the next digit in an incisor-like grip. Some species have fingernails on the big toe. Sometimes referred to as dog monkeys, baboons are very common in the African landscape. Baboons call both Africa and Asia home. They tend to live in the tropical locations most of the time. However, they are also found living in many dry areas. They are versatile and spend a great deal of time living in trees. They also spend time on land too. The distribution for monkeys covers many regions across the world. They tend to live in forest regions where they have a lot of trees around them. Some of them live in the savannas though, or in the mountain regions. There are species of monkeys that only live in the trees. Others live in the trees as well as on land. The evergreen forests are home to a variety of different species of monkeys. Baboons are terrestrial. In captivity, they have been known to live up to 45 years, while in the wild, their life expectancy is about 30 years. Most species of monkeys do very well in captivity. They are able to thrive there with the right conditions. They need to be around others, though, so that their need for socialization can be met. The lifespan could vary from 10 to 50 years, depending on the species of the monkey. Baboons have organized troops containing varying number of members from 5 to 250. They have a very complex level of social organization that takes place among them. This helps them to be able to keep things from becoming chaotic. Part of that successful organization comes in the form of them being able to develop subgroups. There are many dominant males that have several females. They do not allow these females to venture too far from them either. A group of monkeys is commonly referred to as a tribe or troop. The hierarchy of the social structure is very detailed. It doesn't matter if there are only a few members or hundreds of them. There can be many smaller groups within a larger one too. they all have their role within that specific group. The males get aggressive over mating issues, and that is why they are always usually the ones involved. However, many of the monkey species have a female in control. She may fight with the other females as well. In the end, she will get to decide who stays and who goes. Baboons can determine from vocal exchanges what the dominance relations are between individuals. Such situations often cause aggressive fights by the males. Visual threats are usually accompanied by these aggressive fights. These would include a quick flashing of the eyelids, accompanied by a given yawn to show off the teeth. In monkeys, vocalization is the most common method of socialization. They have a variety of sounds that they can use. This can be low chatter, clicking, and even high-pitched yelling that can be heard for long distances. These sounds allow them to be able to create strong bonds, to take care of their young, and even to warn other groups of monkeys to stay away. They will warn each other of potential risks and predators when they can too. They also use non-verbal communication to show emotion. Snuggling a baby is a way for the mom to protect it. At the same time, it helps the young to feel loved and cared for. Adults may sit close to each other and even touch each other's face as a means of socialization. They can use facial expression too in order to show love, fear, anger, or sadness to each other. Grooming, feeding together, and general socialization are key to the well-being of the baboon troops. Baboons are very vocal and communicate not only with about 40 different distinct vocalizations, but with numerous hand and arm gestures and very expressive faces. Grooming is a part of the social behavior for the monkeys too. They take bugs and debris out of the fur of each other. They do this process for hours and hours in a very loving and careful manner. They will be offering social elements to the relationship as they do so through the power of touch. Baboons consume a variety of different plants and leaves. They are slow eaters, and so it may take them hours per day to be able to get enough eating done. Their diets are omnivorous. They eat insects and occasionally prey on fish, trout, and salmon. If available, shellfish, hares, birds, vervet monkeys, and small antelopes. For most monkeys, fruit is the primary food that they will consume. There are hundreds of types of fruits found in the forests where they live. These fruits, though, are seasonal, and so they move around their home habitat to find them. They are able to calculate what will be readily available during particular times of the year. They often spread seeds too from the fruits as they move along. This is part of why the monkey is so important to the habitat. The spreading of the seeds helps to ensure future vegetation will be able to grow. Twigs and dry bark may be part of their diet as well. Many trees have sap, and that too will be something for them to consume. As they venture out too, they may find flowers that they would like to consume too. Bugs and insects can be part of the diet for the monkeys. In baboons, social ranking is what will determine which of the males in a given group will be able to breed with the females that are part of their harem. There can be several days between each of the females being in estrus for the convenience of the male. He will have time to rest between being with each of them. A female initiates mating by presenting her swollen rump to the male's face. Mating is very gentle with the baboons, including the male bringing them food, gentle touches, and hours spent to groom the females. This is all part of ensuring that the female will be receptive to the mating when it occurs. The reproduction process can be full of rituals for the monkeys. The females are attracted to the biggest and strongest males. Those are going to be the leaders of the group. They are the only ones that will breed within that group. This is why there can be plenty of conflicts in a group of monkeys. Females typically give birth after 6 months gestation, usually to a single infant. The young baboon weighs approximately 400 grams and has a black epidermis when born. After 1 year, the young animals are weaned. They reach sexual maturity in 5 to 8 years. The age of maturity can vary among various monkey species. Most of them range from 4 to 8 years of age. The females of any given species tend to mature approximately a year earlier than the males. Once mating has occurred, it is approximately 160 days until the young arrives. Monkeys only give birth every couple of years. They are excellent at caring for the young. In many groups of monkeys, the young will inherit the social hierarchy as their mothers. That will be where they are placed in the order of things, both as a young infant and when they are mature. Their principal predators are now crocodiles, lions, spotted and striped hyenas, leopards, and cheetahs. They are considered a difficult prey for the leopard, though, which is mostly a threat to the young baboons. Although they are not a prey species, baboons have been killed by the black mamba. Humans continue to be the largest problem for them. They are heavily hunted due to the way they look. The culture in these regions has them pegged as being evil. The many species of monkeys have varied relationship with humans. Some are kept as pets, others used as model organisms in laboratories or in space missions. They have been killed in monkey drives or used as service animals for the disabled. In some areas, some species of monkeys are considered agricultural pests and can cause extensive damage to commercial and subsistence crops. In religion and popular culture, monkeys are a symbol of playfulness, mischief, and fun. Now, animals are the bridge between us and the beauty of all that is natural. Now, they show us what's missing in our lives, how to love ourselves more completely and unconditionally. They connect us back to who we are and the purpose of why we are here. Now, we do hope from me and the whole ECOZONE team that you had a lot to learn from this one, and that the next time you go into the wild, you will not call a cheetah a leopard, or a leopard a jaguar, or a chimpanzee a gorilla, or anything else that you have been doing. Feel free to hit us up on our Facebook page, that is at ECOZONE on Facebook, or at my own personal page, which is at Shaban Senyange Kenyi on Facebook, at Shaban Senyange on Instagram, and at Shaban Senyange on Twitter. For now, keep it green and clean.